Now that you have some understanding of word vectors or word embeddings from our last video, in this video we are going to look at how you can get access of word vectors in Spacy library. We are not going to do any text classification in this particular video. That is something we'll do in the next video. To use word embeddings in Spacy, you need to load the large or medium model. So large model you can specify by LG, medium model you can specify by MD. And the difference between these two is this. See, if you go to Spacy English model page, you will find that for a small model, there are no vectors. See, vector, it says zero keys, zero unique vectors. But the medium model has 514 keys and these many unique vectors. Okay, and the each vector has 300 dimension. But the large model has more number of unique vectors. Instead of 20k, you have 514k. Now, if you're confused about what word vectors is, we have already covered it in the last video. So you should have brief overview. In this video, we are just writing our code. To install this large model, you can run this particular command on your command prompt. So something like this. And when you run it, the model is big, so it's gonna take some time, so please have some patience. Now I'm assuming you have downloaded the model. You can write your first statement here. Let's say I want to compare word vectors with different words such as dog, cat, banana, and some unknown garbage word, right? And we can just say dog, for example. And for token in dog, print token, okay, or token.txt, and I want to print another thing called has vector. So if you tab it, this will be a flag indicating if this token has a vector or not. It will also print is OOV. OOV is out of vocabulary, okay? So OOV and has vector. You notice that the common words like dog, cat, banana has vectors, whereas some random word will not have vector. For example, double P, right? Because when Spacy's model was trained, it probably hasn't seen this particular word. And Spacy using Glove embedding, global vectors, and they trained it on some popular English data set, right? And some data set from internet where it has captured general English knowledge, but it doesn't know what the word double P means. Or you can give some regional word, for example, KEM, and it doesn't have any vector, see, false, and out of vocabulary is true. So you can see that Spacy gives out of the box access of a vector. And if you want to print a particular vector, you can print it by saying this, see, dog zero. So zero will be dog, one will be cat, two will be banana, okay? And if you do this dot vector, it will print that vector. See, the size of this vector is 300 dimension. So you can do shape and you will find it's a 300 dimension vector. So Spacy large model comes with inbuilt vector. So the moment you create this document object, you're already getting these individual word vectors. Okay, now let's try to compare these word vectors and see what kind of similarity we get between these words. So I will create another document called bread. Okay, and I will just call it a base token and base token dot vector dot shape. So even you get, by the way, you might ask me, okay, why didn't you do this? Well, that and the sentence both will give you the same embedding, but just to be technically correct, let me do this. Okay, so zeroth word is bread and the vector that you are getting is this particular vector, but since it has only one word, the sentence vector is same as that individual word vector. And the way Spacy works is if you give multiple word, it will, the sentence vector will be the average of individual word vectors, okay? And we'll cover that in more detail later. But now I want to compare this word bread with different words such as, let's say, sandwich, burger, cat, tiger, human, and wheat. Now, when I compare bread with sandwich, they are very similar, right? They appear in the same context. Bread and burger are also kind of matching, but bread and car are not matching. So I'm expecting that the similarity between these two words will be higher, whereas similarity between bread and car should be lower. And you can check that by going over all these tokens. So I'm going token by token, and I'm saying that, okay, print. So I will use Python's format string, and I will say, okay, my token.text, and I want to compare it with base token.text. So I'm comparing all these words with bread, okay? And I will print the similarity. How do you print the similarity? So you can just do token.similarity. So Spacy has this inbuilt function with base token. Base token 0 and base token both will give you the same vector. And you will notice that the similarity between sandwich and bread is higher. So one means they are exactly similar. Okay, so let me do that. So if I do bread here, see, bread and bread is exactly similar. One is exactly similar. Zero is like not similar. So as you get closer towards one, it means more similar. Sandwich and bread is 0.6. Burger and bread 0.4. But look at car and bread. See, 0.06. They're not similar at all. So it's close to zero. Tiger and bread, 0.0. Tiger doesn't eat bread, right? Human eats bread. So there is some similarity. And wheat and bread is more similarity. I want to make sure you understand that this is not some magic bullet, right? You don't give some random words and expect that, okay, this will work perfectly. You will see a lot of issues with this model as well. You have to understand how these models are trained. Let's say you take all the text from Google News and Wikipedia, all the text, okay? And you train this model. The way these models work is they will look at the context of the words. So in the language, if human and bread is appearing together, it tends to give it more similarity. But car and bread, if you look at any Wikipedia article or Google News, anything, any book, car and bread will not appear in a similar context, but wheat and bread will appear in a similar context. Okay, so if two words appear in a similar context, it will have higher similarity. Same thing with, like, let's say profit and loss. Profit and loss will have more similarity. Now, someone may argue why they're more similar. They're exactly opposite. You have to understand, what do you mean by similarity here? This similarity means they're appearing in the same context. So profit and loss would appear in a similar context if you're looking at company's financial document or reading some financial article. That's why they will have more similarity, but actually they're antonyms. Okay, so you are not trying to create some English dictionary here. So folks, please have that understanding clear in your bread, in your brain. I was just going to say bread. All right, so now I will create a function for printing a similarity. So I will use the similar code, okay, same code, and create this function called print similarity. Okay, and I will say base word and the words to compare. This way I can give random words and get the similarity. So my base token would be what? NLP base word, right? And then my document would be NLP words to compare. So the reason I'm creating this function is I want to give it this type of value. I want to compare iPhone with random words, okay? So, and then for token in doc, kind of similar thing, okay? So I'll just use copy paste just to save some time. And when you compare these, you find that Apple and iPhone are 0.43 similar. Samsung and iPhone are 0.67. Now again, someone will argue Apple is more similar to iPhone than Samsung is similar to iPhone. Well, not necessarily. See, again, this model is trained on some Google News articles, let's say some Wikipedia articles. And in news, people tend to compare Samsung and iPhone more versus Apple and iPhone. On whatever text this model is trained, it appears Samsung and iPhone have more similarity. iPhone to iPhone is obviously one. Dog and iPhone, see? Dog and iPhone is 0.08. Dogs don't use iPhone, so that's the reason. Kitten and iPhone. Maybe there are so many pictures of kittens or people making TikTok videos and, you know, they might refer kitten and iPhone together. It's kind of hard to explain this similarity, but you get a sense of it. If two words are appearing in the same context, they will have more similarity. You need to just remember that. Now, we already looked at out of vocabulary here, right? Where if the word doesn't appear in the corpus that you have trained on. Now see, this word cam is from my local regional language. It's an Indian language called Gujarati. On Gujarati language, if I train a model, then it will be able to identify all these Gujarati words, you know, right? All these Gujarati words, it will be able to identify if the model is trained on Gujarati language corpus. But this space's default model is trained on an English corpus. That's why it can understand English. Okay. Now, you can do something like this. So I'm just going to again copy paste. We already looked at like king minus man plus woman. Okay, that kind of equation. And if you compare result with the vector of queen, and the way you can compare this result using cosine similarity. In one of the, I think, other videos on YouTube, let me show you. I think we have talked about cosine similarity. So if you don't know what cosine similarity, just code basics cosine similarity and you can go through this video. Okay, it's very important. This concept will help you in an interview as well. So the cosine similarity, the way you print that is by using this function from sklearn, and you can just compare your result with the queen. So there is a king. If you take the element of man from that king, what is left is, see, king has an authority, king is super rich, king has power. But you take the element of man and add the element of woman, then woman will be queen. And queen also has authority, power, money, all of that. So she has all of that. So you are just replacing the gender and now you get queen. So here you get 0.61 similarity. Now people might think, okay, why is it not close to one? I have explained this before. It's not always perfect, but more than 0.5, you get it, they are considered quite similar. All right, so that's all I had for spacey word vectors. In the future videos, we will look at the word vectors in GenSim, as well as we'll see how you can do text classification, both using spacey word vectors and GenSim word vectors. All right, that's all I had. In the next video, we will do fake versus real news classification using these spacey vectors.